I'm Barbara Kunth, and I've been here in the village 8 years now. I do what I love, and I love all the horticulture here. And one day I saw this gorgeous leaf, this bush, and so I did the leaf. That's what inspired me for that. And I love the cranes here. I love giraffes. And I have this carving at home, and it casts this gorgeous shadow where I sit. I can see that. And so I thought, I want to try to paint that. And it was a bit of a challenge, but I enjoyed it. I'm a registered nurse, and when I retired, my husband gave me a set of watercolor pencils for Christmas. And I thought, well, what do I do now? And we were snowbirds, and we went, and there was a class, and I got hooked.
I'm Joyce DeJean, and I've been living here in South Gardens for 7 years. These are all acrylic, and I do dabble in acrylic. The top one is called Route 30, and that's through Pennsylvania, which is my home state. And as you travel along Route 30, you see a lot of barns that are painted, and the old ones are the mail pouch advertisement. The bubbles was an experiment. I just decided I would try to do it, and it turned out okay. The last one here is called Nightlife, and I wanted to create something that occurs at night. And to me, this is a picture of early life, because some people strive, but they fall short, and others strive, and then only one or two really make it in life. I taught in Broward County at Coral Springs High School. I taught history and psychology, and when I retired, I wanted to do three things, and I would have time to do them: plant flowers, play golf, and paint. And I've done all three.
I'm Marilyn Bowling, and I've lived here about 11 years now. I've lived down here for so long. I came down here in 1960, so I lived in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania before that. So that's where I got most of my art, you know, and then when I got down here, I was too busy raising children to do much of anything. So after I got them out of the home, I started taking some classes. Oh, I'm always very detail-oriented. No, I can't say that it took a long time. I did it with the guidance in a class. This is acrylics. I don't like watercolor. It's too hard to handle. And as far as oils, it's just too messy. So this is a happy medium for the lazy painter.
My name is Leslie Deppenbrock. I live in East Lake, and we've been here 3.5 years. Right now, I'm taking lessons from Boca Raton Museum School of Art. This one is oil, that one is needlepoint, and this is water. I just like to do it. It's my own kind of thing, and I had it professionally framed, so it really looks nice to make it do that. My favorite is that one. It was Notre Dame. I call it yesterday, which is the burning area, and today and yesterday. I combined two different pieces of work. The old one, which is very standard and everybody's seen that, and then that was from a newspaper article. And that brings it forward. It still gets me every so often when I look at that. This one is a watercolor. It's a broken window. And I wanted to learn what that was like, how you do that. And I got it from my uncle's barn has a broken window, and some other, I took a picture. And I think I have had people tell me they feel like I'm gonna get cut if they pick it up. I have that sense myself to it.
My name is David Thompson, and next month I will have lived here 7 years. My wife and I did a lot of traveling after we retired. Most of these pictures are out of Africa. This is probably my favorite picture. We were just walking along a trail, and there's this bird sitting on a tree stump with this gigantic grasshopper in his mouth. Just to catch that, and he's looking at me, I think that's one of the best pictures I've ever taken, so that's my favorite. The rest are just coming animals that we saw along the way.
My name is Joanne Culligan. I live at John Knox since October 2019. We moved to Florida in 1985, and I went to work at American Express, and I retired from American Express. primarily work in watercolor paint, transparent watercolor. But my thing is I like to work on different surfaces or media. This one is a pouring. The background was all poured. And then I did the painting over the pouring. Over here is Golden Delicious. That's gold gesso painted on watercolor paper. And then gouache is painted over it, which is a very thick watercolor. That's Goldie. And Goldie, I saw a similar picture in a watercolor magazine, and I decided to do it in watercolor crayon. Oh. And you put the crayon down, and then you apply some water, and it kind of blends it. So that was a lot of fun to do also. I've started just before I retired. I think I started about 14 years ago. And I was looking for something that would occupy my time, but not be too cumbersome. Well, little did I know I had to get an art studio outside the home because I just started gathering more and more supplies. But I like watercolor because it dries fairly quickly, and it's water soluble, so cleanup is very easy.
I'm Sandy Camp, and I've lived here a year and a half. These two are transitional paintings. This is my favorite painting. These are an important paintings because this duo is when I went from painting into jewelry. And so I started to incorporate jewelry in my artwork. And then I made jewelry. I made enamel, cloisonné enamel, and I taught enamel. And I'm going to be teaching enameling here. The one up above I did here because I teach the watercolor and acrylic. And it was just such an inspiring picture for me. It made me feel so like in another wonderful world, the waterfall.
Mary Farenbeck, and I've been here since September, 7 months. I was living in Sarasota, but I'm from New York City. I started sculpting, I guess, in about 2009, somewhere about that, when I was living in Sarasota. And I was actually taking a Spanish class and ended up watching a class on ceramics, and it looked so fun that I joined up and started the class. And my very first work turned out to be good. So I was impressed with myself and continued studying. And since then I've been taking classes off and on. I believe this piece I did when I was in Sarasota, and it's just a classic nude. And I call it svelte because at the time I was a little overweight, so I was thinking positive. Yeah. And the other one is a Roman emperor, and I like Italian history, so that's what I've been doing, yeah.
I'm Elaine Scobie. I've been here now 5 years. Yeah, I was down here since 1976. I was a linotype operator. And then I went into computers. And then I decided when we moved down here, I started a hibiscus nursery. And we traveled all over the state every weekend selling plants. So we had a lot of good times. Well, in 1992, a friend of mine asked, would I like to go to a dollhouse show? And I thought they meant little dolls. And I went and I saw all these beautiful things made, and they mentioned they had one opening. So I signed right up, and I've been going there ever since. I wanted to learn to make the dolls because they're so expensive to buy. They're like over $300 to buy. I can make one for about $50. So I decided I'd take classes. Then I fell in love with woodworking. And the gentlemen here at the RAS workshop have offered to cut any wood or anything I needed. They are wonderful to help me.
My name is Susan Seidler, and I'm married to George Baczynski. We like to make it hard for people. I can't think of a time that I didn't dabble in drawing and painting. From the time I was a little kid, I went to what they called a progressive school at the time. So we had a lot of art. We made murals and did stuff with clay. And so it's always been a part of my life. Well, you've got these landscapes that I did with oil. paint that have that you do a lot of rubbing on, and you can see the colors are very soft and they go together, and there's some blending of colors. That's the beauty of that method of painting. And a lot of fingers involved, rubbing it on. I felt like I was putting my blusher on sometimes when I was painting.
My name is Ken McAllis. We moved in July 1st, and we live in the Villas right across from Heritage. I've taught in Massachusetts, New Jersey, and Florida. Well, this is my favorite painting. No, people say, you know, that self-portrait doesn't look like you. Well, it was meant to be a joke. I favor watercolor, but I like to do oils. I have gone to Cape Cod almost every summer of my life, and there's a mixture here of oils and watercolors. Grigio was sitting on the couch one day. That's our dog. He just turned 9 years old. He's very famous on the property now. This is a great hobby for me. I have a small desk, and I sit there and try to do painting. While we're indoors now, I try to do one a day at least, just to keep in practice. And I'm self-taught, by the way.
I'm Tom Warden, and I've been here about 11 months. Well, I'm originally from Detroit, Michigan, and I'm an industrial engineer by trade. I worked for IBM for many years, and so I've been retired for quite a few years, so I've got these little hobbies. I like working in wood, now I'm doing this. They're ceramic tiles made out of porcelain, and I just draw a design on a piece of plywood and glue them on, then grout it. And the longest part of doing it is the design itself. It took me probably 2 weeks just to come up with each of the designs. I didn't do a lot of erasing. I got probably about 10 or 12 at home. I just started doing this about 2 years ago. For many years, I did geometric. I was an engineer, so I left brain. But now I'm just going to a little more abstract, so I enjoy this more. My wife used to say it keeps me out of the pool halls.